Self S.V. Katkur, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are going to continue from previous lecture, properties of pure substance. At the end of this session, student will be able to apply knowledge of basic thermodynamic concepts such as specific heat, sensible heat, latent heat, and dryness fraction. Student will be able to calculate the heat required for wet, dry, as well as saturated steam. These are the contents we are going to discuss in this session. First, we will define what do you mean by specific heat, sensible heat, and latent heat. Then we will move towards the quality of steam, that is wet, saturated, superheated steam. Then what do you mean by degree of superheat and dryness fraction. Then molecular diagram and references. Definitions. Before moving towards the definitions, in previous lecture we have studied the steam generation at a constant pressure, which takes place at 1 bar. Here that 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 line represents the steam generation at a constant pressure. 2 is the saturated liquid point, 4 is the saturated vapor point, and 4 to 5 is the superheating. First one, that is specific heat, that is denoted by Cp. How you are going to define the Cp? That is nothing but, let us take one example. If you are having in a container 1 kg of water, which is at 20 degrees Celsius, and suppose if I supply Q amount of heat, whatever it may be, Q amount of heat, if there is a change in 1 degree Celsius temperature of that water, means the temperature of the water starts, means change from 20 to 21, that quantity of heat is called as specific heat. Now specific heat of water is 4.187 kilojoule per kg Kelvin, means for unit mass and for unit degree Celsius, if you supply 4.187 kilojoule amount of heat to water, then there is 1 degree Celsius or 1 degree Kelvin change in temperature of that water. That is called as specific heat of water. Moving towards the next definition, sensible heat. Now if you consider this 1 to 2 line, if you consider this 1 to 2 line, that is called as sensible heat. Sensible heat is simply defined as when you are going to supply the amount of heat, if there is a change in temperature but there is no change in the phase, that type of heat is called as sensible heat. Means what? If you are going to heat the water from 0 degree Celsius to 100 degree Celsius, which is at 1 bar, whatever the quantity of heat we have supplied, that type of heat or that quantity of heat is called as sensible heat, because there is change in temperature but the water will remain in a liquid phase itself, means there is no change in the phase. That type of heat is called as sensible heat, and the sensible heat is denoted by HF. Moving towards the next definition, that is latent heat. Now if consider at point 2, all the, what you can say, in previous lecture we have studied, all the points are at a saturated level and all the molecules are in liquid state, and whatever the heat you are going to supply to convert that heat from liquid to vapor, that type of heat is called as latent heat. And the unit of the latent heat is joule per kg, and that is denoted by HHFG. In latent heat, there is a change in phase but the temperature remains constant, means that is exactly reverse. In sensible, there is change in temperature but no change in phase. In latent heat, there is change in phase but the temperature remains constant, means this 2 to 4 line, it will take place at the constant temperature of 100 for normal atmospheric pressure, that is of 1 bar. Dryness fraction. Dryness fraction, it is nothing but, it is denoted by X, which is equal to the ratio of, if you consider a given quantity of mixture, in that, suppose for example, out of 100 molecules, 40 molecules are in steam and 60 molecules are in water, then you can define the dryness fraction. It is the ratio of amount of steam molecules divided by total molecules contained in a mixture. Means as I have given example, out of 100, 40 molecules are steam, means 40 divided by 40 plus 60, you will get the dryness fraction x equal to 0.4. Considering this example, at 0.2, dryness fraction x is 0, and at 0.4, the dryness fraction is 1, because all the molecules are in vapor state. And in between 2 to 3, at 0.3, dryness fraction is greater than 0 and less than 1. Now, quality of steam. The quality of steam can be bifurcated or classified as wet steam, superheated steam, and saturated steam. Now, total heat contained by the wet steam is given by HF plus XHFG. At 0.3, wet steam is there. HF is the sensible heat contained by the water, plus X is the dryness fraction, and HFG is the latent heat. If, let us say, suppose for example, X is 0.5, means that is absorbed half of this latent heat, therefore HFG multiplied by 0.5. That will give you the quantity of the latent heat, and whereas HF is the sensible heat contained by the water at a given temperature, at a given pressure. Now pause this video for a moment and try to write the equation for total heat contained by the saturated steam. Now the total heat contained by the saturated steam is given by the equation HF plus HFG, and whereas for dry saturated steam, the value of X becomes 1, means at 0.4. At 0.3, the value of X is in between 0 to 1. Similarly, if you want to write the total heat contained by the superheated steam, the equation is given by HF plus HFG plus MCP delta T, whereas MCP delta T is the heat contained by the superheated, whereas that delta T is called as the degree of superheat. How you are going to find out the delta T? That is temperature of the superheated steam minus temperature of saturation temperature at a given pressure. Now we will take one simple example so that you will get the brief idea how to calculate the total heat required. Now here the question is, determine the amount of heat which should be supplied to 2 kg of water, which is at 25 degrees Celsius, to convert it into steam at 5 bar and 0.9% dry. Now what will the first, we are going to write down the given things, and as the pressure is given as 5 bar, we will use the steam table and we are going to find the value of HF and HFG at 5 bar. By using the steam table, we will get at 5 bar HF equal to 640.1 kilojoule per kg, and HFG is equal to 2107.4. Now I want to calculate the total heat required, which is at a superheated, let us see, at 5 bar. Now you know the equation, as the 0.9% dry means that is wet steam. The equation to calculate the total heat required by the wet steam is given by HF plus XHFG. Now you know the values. Now this equation is applicable for 1 kg of wet steam, which is given by HF plus XHFG. We will put the values and we will get the total heat required for 1 kg of steam. And whereas, as the temperature, whatever this HF is there, that will give you the total heat required from 0 to 100 degree Celsius or from 0 to saturation temperature. But already that water is at 25 degree Celsius, we are going to subtract the total heat or sensible heat contained by the water, which is calculated by, which is given by MCP delta T. Then this equation is for unit mass. and the net quantity of heat to be supplied per kg of water is total heat minus sensible heat. Therefore, this will come as 2432.26, and this is for per kg. Now, as the total mass is given as 2 kg, we are going to multiply by this by 2, and we will get 4864.52 kilojoule amount of heat. Means what? If you want to convert the 2 kg of water, which is at 25 degrees Celsius, into 5 bar and 0.9 dry, we have to supply 4864.52 kilojoule amount of heat. These are the references. Thank you.